Hachette Audio presents Diet for the Mind, the latest science on what to eat to prevent Alzheimer's and cognitive decline, from the creator of The Mind Diet. Written by Dr. Martha Clare Morris with 80 recipes by Laura Morris. Read by Deanna McGovern. Please enjoy the PDF of recipes that accompanies this audiobook. In loving memory of James Joseph Morris Jr., a spirit who consumed food and all that life has to offer with gusto. Introduction, where the heart and mind meet. I believe that some of the best contributions to the greater good begin with our passions, and this book is no different. In 2009, my daughter Laura and I began planning what would eventually become Diet for the Mind. At the time, Laura was a certified personal trainer and nutrition consultant about to begin her training at the Northwest Culinary Academy of Vancouver. She wanted to build on her already formidable skills in creating meals that were both delicious and nutritious. Simultaneously, I was establishing a new academic program in nutrition at Rush University in Chicago called Nutritional Medicine. The program was designed to teach practicing medical professionals, doctors, nurses, pharmacists, dentists, physical therapists, and the like, about the influence of nutrition on health and disease. Unfortunately, nutrition education is barely a footnote in medical training programs, yet it's at the core of all matters in health and disease. This program was an attempt to bridge the gap in U.S. medical education. As part of the nutritional medicine program, I invited the leading experts in nutrition science to Chicago to lecture on different diseases. The courses were designed to take place in a two-day seminar series three times a year. For each seminar, we flew in three or four distinguished guest lecturers from all over the country. Because of my doctoral training in nutritional epidemiology at the Harvard School of Public Health, recently renamed the Harvard T.H. Chan School of Public Health, I was fortunate to have many mentors and college friends who were the best of the best with respect to nutrition and health. Among these famous guest lecturers were faculty of Harvard University and the Harvard Studies on Nutrition and Health, including Walter Willett, Frank Sachs, Joanne Manson, Michelle Williams, Eric Rim, Susan Hankinson, and Alberto Asherio, and the faculty of the Friedman School of Nutrition Science and Policy at Tufts University, including Erwin Rosenberg, Catherine Tucker, and Sarah Booth. For each seminar, we invited all the lecturers to my home for a cozy gathering around a brain-healthy dinner. Laura created and prepared the meals, and each course was paired with a different craft beer created by my son-in-law, Peter Crowley, husband of my older daughter, Claire, an international award-winning brewmaster and owner of Haymarket Pub and Brewery. Laura and I had many discussions around the planning of the meal courses so that they merged her dazzling skills with what we know about the science of nutrition and the brain. Once the meal plan was set, we enlisted Pete to pair each course with one of his craft beers to enhance the flavors and essence of the culinary experience. As each dinner course was served, Laura and other members of our family described the food and beer contents and their pairing flavors. We had such fun planning and executing these dinners, and our guests enjoyed the amazing talents of Chef Laura and Beer Maestro Pete. However, the star of these dinners, so lovingly prepared and delivered in honor of our celebrated guests, was my late husband, Jim. Jim had been diagnosed with head and neck cancer in February 2008. He was unable to eat or drink by mouth very early on in his 4.5-year battle with the disease, and by 2011, he was barely able to talk. Despite his inability to enjoy the feast and participate in the lively conversation, Jim, the ultimate master of hospitality, participated in one of his favorite activities by assisting Laura as sous chef and serving each dinner course to the guests. Jim died in May 2012 and was not able to be part of the program's later dinners. Other family members stepped in to help, including my sister-in-law, Louise, and future daughter-in-law, Rachel. The discussions Laura and I had around the planning and preparation of these dinners were seeds for this book. It is the culmination of our mutual passion for nutrition and health, and most of all, for the love of family and friends. Food is central to the expression of love. My passion for nutrition arose with my first pregnancy and grew with my desire to ensure that my children were as healthy as they could possibly be. My other passion is science, and I was able to marry the two during my doctoral training in nutritional epidemiology at the Harvard School of Public Health. For the past 20 years, I have been at the forefront of research in an area with tremendous implications for public health: the link between Alzheimer's disease, cognitive decline, and diet. In 2015, my team put all this research together to develop the MIND Diet Score, which we found was associated with reduced risk of Alzheimer's disease and slower cognitive decline. It is this research that I describe in part one of the book. I am eager to share what I've learned about this cutting-edge science, as well as to share nutritious, easy-to-prepare recipes that support it. The 80 selections in part two of this book were created by Laura, who not only trained at a renowned culinary institute, but also grew up in a home where cooking and family meals were treasured and good nutrition was emphasized. Many of these recipes are family favorites for casual dinners or special occasions. They're quick and easy to make, budget-friendly, and ideal for everyday living. Both delicious and satisfying, the meals can also be used as a template for daily or weekly food plans, or if you are an experienced cook, as a healthy base for your own dishes. Laura and I hope you will enjoy them while also reaping the benefits they're bound to create. Jim's love of food, family, and the camaraderie of meals and conversation is a fond memory and an important foundation of our children's upbringing. The Morris family table is famous for good food and conversation. We've shared our table with many guests, and Jim was always a central part of these meals. This book is dedicated to him. He endeavored to enjoy every second of his 66 years of life, and he made everyone around him enjoy life too. Part 1. MIND-HEALTHY Science. Chapter 1. Cognitive Decline and Dementia. As we age, our brains age too. Our ability to think slows down, and we may experience occasional difficulty in, for example, recalling where we left our keys or retrieving a word or name. By all accounts, this is considered a normal degree of cognitive decline. It is a very different and more painful story, however, when you can no longer remember the way to get home or the names of your grandchildren. That is the experience of those who suffer from dementia, including Alzheimer's disease. No wonder dementia and cognitive decline are among the most feared consequences of aging. Being able to reason, remember, and make decisions the way we always have connects us to the identity, personality traits, and relationships we spend our lives building. To live out our golden years with a healthy degree of brain power is what we all hope for our future. I am happy to say that there is a great deal we can do to make this the reality for much of our lifetime. Dementia is a widespread and growing public health problem. In 2015, Alzheimer's disease, the leading type of dementia, affected more than 5 million adults in the United States and was the sixth leading cause of death. And while Alzheimer's disease accounts for some 60 to 80% of all cases of dementia, many adults experience other forms of dementia, with symptoms including memory loss, difficulties with communication and language, trouble with focus and attention, and errors in visual perception, reasoning, and judgment. Fully 1 in 3 seniors dies with Alzheimer's or another form of dementia. At this time, there is no cure for Alzheimer's disease, and the treatments are largely ineffective. But take heart, the picture for prevention is not as bleak as we once thought. At one time, Alzheimer's disease was thought to be genetic, and the signs of dementia, like memory loss and confusion, were thought to be inevitable consequences of aging. However, over the last 30 to 40 years, researchers have identified many factors that can cause or prevent the disease, most of which can be managed with effective treatments and/or through healthy lifestyle choices. This means that it is possible to delay the symptoms of dementia in later life by taking control of your health in your young and middle-aged adult years. And because many of these factors are known to be important for heart health, by adopting healthy lifestyle choices, you will be increasing your chances of maintaining not only a healthy brain, but a healthy heart, too. Rest assured that debilitating cognitive decline does not have to be your destiny. In fact, in this book, you will learn many ways to keep your brain functioning at its best and your overall health vibrant as you age. And a lot of this has to do with what is on your plate. I'm often asked whether young or middle-aged adults need to be concerned with changing their diet to prevent Alzheimer's disease or to keep their brain healthy in old age. And the answer is a resounding yes. Key studies that followed young adult populations into old age observed that the high levels of blood pressure, blood cholesterol, and obesity in middle age were associated with increased risk of developing Alzheimer's disease.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.